What's going on, y'all? This is the Ratio coffee maker. Can you see this thing? 300-ish, 340-ish bucks, okay? It automatically does the same thing every time.
Burns my mouth.
Delicious, expressive coffee, kept hot for hours because you have this thermal carafe. Very pretty looks on the countertop, hugely durable, and such a nicer experience than the cheaper stuff. There's some plastic for sure, but it's a dense, matte kind of finish. It feels very considered, all said and done. Ultimately, every day with this thing, this is like I reviewed the big brother of this, which is quite a bit more expensive. When you think about a coffee maker, you're like, what, 90 bucks, 150 bucks, but maybe $200? So this is more than maybe a lot of people in the market are thinking of spending. But it gives killer EDD. Everyday delight. If you have multiple coffee drinkers at home, this thing is clutch. Like I said, it automatically does the same thing every time. That means we've got a bloom. You push the one button, right? Which actually tricked my friend Jesse. He thought it was a push button when really it's just a capacitive. It's just like, oh, glowing light just looks so like it's like, hello, Chase. We're preparing your coffee now. I hope you had a good rest. It has a bloom, okay? This is important for fresh coffee to do a little bit of off-gassing, right? You don't want that getting trapped in the flavors of the coffee. Thanks, Ratio. In just a minute, I'm gonna talk to you about like the specifics of how we found making coffee best on this thing. But the point is, the craft, the like hot carafe, I just get to do that thing that's like, you know, like 2 p.m.? When you just like, you go over and you just kind of shake it and there's a little bit left and it's still hot. That in the morning I come over here, I set it up, I push my button, I go off and make breakfast for my kids or something. That's a big deal. Some of my favorite like professional coffee people who are friends of mine actually have this exact unit and they use it every day. Why? Because they don't want to be doing pour over every single day. Especially if you're making coffee for multiple coffee drinkers. If you have multiple people in the house that are drinking coffee, this thing is worth it. It's worth the money as far as I'm concerned, okay? Because you get these lovely interactions every day. The process, the actual build and machinery of this stuff feels really good. Talking about that in a second. You get hot coffee that lasts, you know, several hours, which I really dig. Beautiful interactions, right? And a great process. What's fun about it is because it does the same thing every time, you can really dial it in. Okay, so let's talk about the elements, all right? First of all, you have the Ratio unit itself. Hardcore stainless steel around the outside. It feels extremely durable. BPA-free reservoir. It is plastic, but the glass tubes on the inside, they're borosilicate glass, which can be much more resistant to absorbing or leaching flavor than the rubber or plastic tubes that you're finding in a lot of like mass market coffee makers. The carafe itself is stainless steel, it's insulated, and it has a large opening so you can get in there and clean it out. It keeps coffee hot for hours with the top that like just seals on like this. You put it on with a little bit of a burp, burp. It's just a tiny little turn, and then you have this guy to pour it out, keeps it hot for a long ass time. Then there is the basket, which is a flat bottom basket. We just use a standard Melitta flat bottom filter. You can get them everywhere. It's a more forgiving brewing process with a flat bottom. And I've actually been super stoked by how expressive the cup has been, the final product. Okay, so here's like the carafe and basket sort of all put together with a third piece I'll show you here. So you, when you pull this out, you're just pulling the whole thing. Then the basket goes onto this little stand, okay? This little extra piece of plastic, right? But it's nice because it's a dripper catcher. The final piece is the piece on top of the basket right here, which I call the basket gasket. What it does is increases the temperature of the final brew. It doesn't increase the temperature of the water. The water's still coming in at right around 200 degrees, right where we want it, right where the Specialty Coffee Association says it needs to be. But this gasket on top, you'll see it just seals in around the shower head It increases the final cup of coffee temperature by about 5 degrees. Now, instead of this system here, you can go with a Chemex. Fits right underneath here, and then you can use like the Able cone metal filter that I like to use for, you know, for garbage purposes and whatever. It's just, it's nice, but I prefer this every day. Absolutely. Why? Because this thermal carafe is actually dope. In use, the first several times I was just like, oh man, I gotta like put that down, gotta take this top, put this on, lock it in, and then I ended up getting used to it. You need a place to put this dripper thing, okay? At first I was like, but then it did so good day after 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 day, multiple coffee drinkers in the house, that it was like, oh, thank you, ratio. Again, that come back like a few hours later and just like give a little jiggle. And you notice there's some left, it's like, yes. So I brought over my coffee professional friend, Sarah Jr., to the house to take this thing through its paces. We ended up optimizing the brew for that top line right there. So filling up the water to there, what did we find? We found that...
We're talking 63 grams of coffee. Mm-hmm. I've adjusted our grind a little bit on this grinder over here.
To make it a little coarser.
Yes, because I think that it was in contact with the water for too long.
Okay.
It's tasting up.
The coarser the grind, the faster the water will flow through. By the way, there's an amazing talk with Sarah Jr. about coffee, the ethics, the global ethics of coffee, about finding your daily ritual over at my Patreon page. Thanks, patrons. So it's cheaper than its big brother, the Ratio 8. It has a slightly smaller footprint, which is really helpful in a lot of the places that we've stayed. Your coffee stays hot for hours. There's intense durability. It's totally serviceable. Like, the company is very highly rated, and there's a lot of people who have like sent theirs in, got it repaired, got it back. You're not going to do that with other coffee makers out there. You're going to be buying something that's going into the landfill, right? Not so with the Ratio. So it's a bit over $300 for an epic everyday companion. And if you're a coffee drinker, if you love this stuff, which I kind of go in and out. Like, coffee is liquid optimism for me. I go from like, what's the point? Nothing's gonna change anyways, to like, let's give it a try. That's valuable for me. Even if it does affect my sleep negatively, even if it does affect, like I'm working on it. We're all working on it. You know, I think like how coffee works, it doesn't actually stimulate you. It inhibits the part of you that makes you feel sleepy. Chemistry, man. I delight every time I find a product that's actually like good to use. Like, you treat this well, it will treat you well. That's awesome. None of this is paid. They sent me this. They absolutely sent me this to try out. Like, I love Mark and what he's been doing. It's been awesome to see the company grow. It's been awesome to see like the fan base sort of develop online, because the truth is, you impact my daily life. Like, you're really part of my gear. I don't have a lot of gear, but what I do have, I freaking use, right? This episode is brought to you by Trade Coffee. Trade is an online service that delivers great coffee to your door. Why is this important? Because you're probably gonna want some variety in your life. This thing is amazing because it does the same thing every time. So once you dial it in, you can kind of go like, how does this coffee taste? Oh, wow. Turns out I really like Guatemalan coffee, or I like the bright, juicy Ethiopians, right? So thanks to Trade Coffee. When you use that, you're supporting some coffee, some part of the coffee world that I think is important. You're also supporting this channel, okay? Thank you. Okay, y'all, that is it. Get on the email list over at matterful.co. I'll put a link to that below. We're gonna be doing a giveaway soon. All of the giveaway will be happening through that email list. If you're already on that list, you're already in the giveaway. If you're not already on that list, get on the list, because we don't spam and shit. Shout out to my patrons. Thanks for your support. The talk with Sarah Jr. is up there. Support the channel. Support independent makers. Holler at your boy over at Patreon. And other than that, I hope you're well. I hope you've got the buzz that you need in your life. I hope you're navigating your buzz well, right? Have you seen a lot of ebb and flow over your life? Another video that I have inside of Patreon is a video I did about like sort of my cannabis tips. I really think, you know, a lot of places have become legal for cannabis. It's a really different world when you live in a cannabis legal world. Cannabis and coffee is sort of like the old school hipster speedball, hippie speedball rather. Now it's the hipster speedball. Thanks for watching. That's all for now. Goodbye.